Hello and welcome to the ASN Live. This is Neha Gupta. Now let's have a look on the top three stories of our day. Finance and Revenue Secretary Hasmukh Adhia said that the All Power GST Council will consider bringing petroleum products under Goods and Services Tax, that is GST, and it could happen in phases. One of the demands that is there before us, we will see. Everything will happen in stages, Hasmukh Adhia said in an event in New Delhi. Presently, diesel, petrol, crude oil, natural gas and aviation turbine fuel are outside the purview of goods and services tax. The state's government can impose value-added tax on these items. The finance ministry has expressed its intention to include natural gas and ATF within the purview of the goods and services tax soon. We have done a lot, but it doesn't mean that there is no scope for betterment of the existing system. We still believe that we need to do a lot more and we are working in that direction, Adhia said. In order to curb fake news and to reduce the spreading of misinformation, Twitter has suspended a whopping number of accounts between May and June this year. It is estimated that Twitter has suspended more than 70 million accounts in May and June, and the pace has continued in July, the Post reported on 6th of July. The company has also suspended 13 million accounts during a week of bot banning activity in mid-May. The companies have been taking steps such as deleting user accounts, introducing updates, and actively monitoring content to help users avoid being a victim to fake content. It is hard to believe that 70 million accounts were affected when Twitter has only 336 million monthly active users, said Webbush analyst Michael Pachter. If the 70 million were mostly active accounts, the affected accounts would have been screaming bloody murder, he added. In May, it identified and challenged more than 9.9 million potentially spammy or automated accounts per week, compared with the 6.4 million in December 2017. Tapsee Pannu and Rishi Kapoor are all set to deliver a power-packed performance with the upcoming courtroom drama titled Mulk. The film is directed by Anubhav Sinha and is shot extensively in Banaras and Lucknow. Today, the makers have finally released the trailer for the film. Unlike other light-hearted films, this film seems to be an intense journey through the courtroom. The journey is of the accused Murad Ali Muhammad, that is Rishi Kapoor, and the defense lawyer Aarti Mohammed, that is Tapsee Pannu. At the beginning itself, the trailer reveals that Prateek Babbar, who is Rishi Kapoor's son, is a terrorist and is the reason for a bomb blast in the city. Prateek goes absconding and this leads to the police knocking down Rishi Kapoor's home and arresting him and other members of the family, assuming that they know about their son's whereabouts. The next few seconds has some strong dialogues by Ashutosh Rana, who is public prosecutor, accusing Rishi and his family. Then there is a twist in the tale when apparently Tapsee finds a loophole in the investigation and questions Rajat Kapoor, who is the investigation officer in the courtroom. And with this, we have to come to the end of the today's news on ASN Live. Stay tuned for more updates.